30 miles an hour for all the streets would be perfect.
Cape Coral City leaders are sick of speeders, and there is a new plan to slow them down across the entire city. Well, it could make neighborhoods safer. It could also make for a longer commute for you.
And tonight's cover story here on ABC 7, we're showing you how changing the speed in Cape Coral could save lives.
The speed limit on Denise Colachico's street in Cape Coral used to be 35 miles an hour.
It is very dangerous. We've had a lot of mailboxes taken out.
Neighbors fought for a speed limit change, and they got it lowered to 30. But people who live there say the change hasn't done much.
They still speed by. They're hurrying to get to the light.
Well, it's a concern because this is a residential neighborhood, and all residential neighborhoods should have a speed limit of 25 miles an hour.
She may think so, but it doesn't always work that way. Public Works says sometimes they're asked to do studies on what the right speed should be on a street, and the research shows higher than what the neighbors want.
The traffic manager actually said, be careful, we could raise that to 40.
But not this time. The city is now introducing an ordinance that would make the maximum speed limit 30 miles an hour on residential streets. Basically, the streets in neighborhoods, not the main arteries of the city.
I think it took them too long to make this ordinance. I think it's a great idea. 30 miles an hour for all the streets would be perfect.
Here's why it matters so much. There are more than 250,000 traffic accidents every year in Florida, and 2,900 of those are deadly. By lowering speed limits, the city hopes to lower that number.
I think that's a good start, but I think they really need to be lower in residential areas.
Now, we are not expecting a final vote today. In fact, the next public hearing is going to be 2 weeks from today.